And we are back with some more SmackDown. We got a good few things happening. Batista is a call out. Yeah. Go ahead and start the show.
And welcome to SmackDown. We are live with this capacity crowd, ready to kick things off. You don't see a match card like that very often, so don't you dare change that channel.
And start with this. Supertone. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't mean to be coughing in your eyes or ears. So hopefully you guys aren't wearing headphones. I mean, even if you weren't, it's still a little disrespectful. But I mean, I can't really control that. But it is what it is. Supertone gonna cut a promo.
He really loves that mic.
He's ready to lay it all out right here.
I've never seen.
He's not going to keep us waiting, so let's find out.
He has. Hey man, we've had great times together. Hopefully, unlike never again, Peter Pan. There comes a time in every man's life where he has to grow up and take flight on his own.
You mad, bro? I guess so.
Inspiration I needed to believe in myself. Something changed. All of you just kept asking for more and more. Everything I have, everything I am, everything I wanted to be, I left in this room, and now I'm taking it all back. Find yourselves another hero. Y'all are upset, huh? You think I care? I don't anymore. That was the old me. Now your voice is literally sounding like white noises. White, it all sounds like white noise. It all blends together, so shut up. If I ever find myself doing something for the approval of the WWE Universe again, it'll be the day I take off these boots and leave them in the middle of the ring. I'd rather end this right here than ever let you just dictate what I do.
This place is electric after but that. What did we just see? Wow, just awesome. Well, I'm not sure if we can top that, but we will do our best as we move.
I can't see his promo score. That was amazing. It was really high. He did cut a pretty good promo.
First match of the night. Here we go. Stay right where you... Singles action is up next. You're not going to want to miss this. It's Randy Savage versus Andre the Giant.
Going to settle the score.
I'm going to be playing as Randy Savage.
Okay, ready for this matchup here tonight. And what's he doing?
What
is he doing? Is he inviting somebody else out here?
Ricky's doing it? Well, yeah.
And his opponent from Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing in at 234 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys.
And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as our opener. I mean, it could very well have been our main event. Okay.
And before we go any further, I'd like to extend a very Merry Christmas to our WWE Universe watching at home.
Oh, I echo those sentiments, Michael. And I hope that Santa was good to everybody out there. Even you, Corey.
I hope he brings you coal, Byron. Accolades of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat speak for themselves. Steamboat brings the fight to all challengers. You can be sure the Dragon will be at his absolute best.
If you haven't hit record yet, now might be a good time to do that. These guys are going to have a match you'll want to watch over and over again.
The WWE Universe here in Baton Rouge is amped up and ready to go, guys.
Now we have Randy Savage on the attack.
Let's talk about Ricky Steamboat for a moment. For those who are unfamiliar with him, what can they anticipate out of him here?
WWE is the best bargain in sports entertainment in the world, and this match is just further proof.
Randy Macho Man Savage is one of the most unpredictable, volatile, and intense superstars to ever lace up a pair of boots. The term Macho Madness was not coined by accident.
And the strike connects.
Sit out, pile driver. He's looking good now, guys. Nobody can sustain a drop like that, Michael. Now Randy Savage is keeping up a good tempo.
He's throwing the rule book out the window.
Byron, you spoke earlier about the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and if there's one thing that's for sure, Savage is one of the most intense.
Sit out, pile driver. This could be it.
Did you hear that thud? God.
Randy Savage is looking to fly.
He's not getting up.
You can't like his chances.
Look out. From the Macho Man.
I was trying to replay this one. You don't recognize that. I'm going to be doing another one.
Randy Savage is going up.
He's definitely done, especially after this one.
Randy Savage.
Elbow drop from the Macho Man.
Wow, let's see that again.
Man, he is simply a walking highlight reel.
Will he be victorious?
What?
Okay. Whoops, not even close.
What was he thinking?
Because the match is definitely wrong. Okay. I have no idea how to do that. I don't know what I'm doing with it. Am I doing it right? I think I am. It looks like I did it right.
Oh, the reversal by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
What's this kind of thing? Can I go behind the ring? I need to test that out.
But I wish I could tell you guys what this superstar thinks of this week's power rankings, but when I asked, the only thing I got was a no comment.
And there's the reversal from Randy Savage. Byron, he may be down for good. That wouldn't surprise me at all, not after the beating he's taken. He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in. Cutting it close here, guys.
What a coward. He's trying to get himself counted out, Cole.
He wants no part of the outside. Perfectly placed elbow. And Byron, he's still down after that one.
Yeah, that did some big time damage, Michael.
Randy Savage with the offense. He doesn't appear to be in a hurry to get up here.
I just don't think he has it in him anymore.
I think Randy Savage is done playing.
Oh, done playing.
Elbow drop! That has got to be it.
I guess I wasn't done playing, but I still insist that I'm doing another elbow drop the first one to the second one now.
Randy Savage got the kick out again. And look who's here. Look who's here.
Why not get the best seat in the house? The best view of what's going on.
They're just disrespecting this young man, Corey. That's all this is about.
Mind games, Cole.
Man, this guy has a lot of enemies.
Up next, we have singles action.
It will be Eddie Guerrero versus a formidable opponent.
Every time, Eddie. He's not my favorite wrestler, but I love Eddie Guerrero. I love his. It's so sad. It really is. I miss Guerrero. My favorite is Shawn Michaels. But Eddie Guerrero, he was something special.
Making his way to the ring from El Paso, Texas, weighing in at 228 pounds.
I think it's about to be a highlight reel.
WWE Universal Champion, Eddie Guerrero.
And before the match could even begin, we have a brawl on our hands.
Wow, that's a heck of a holiday present for the WWE Universe.
I saw you trying to attack me.
There it is. Well done.
Oftentimes in our business, the only way for personal issues to be ultimately resolved is two superstars enter the squared circle and go one-on-one in a good old-fashioned wrestling match.
Aside from Saxton's commentary, this has all the makings of an epic match. The WWE Universe here in Baton Rouge is amped up and ready to go, guys. Sometimes all it takes is a basic strike.
To see what Batista is going to do.
So taking a look at Eddie Guerrero, any thoughts come to mind?
What, in your opinion, can the WWE Universe expect from him here?
Going to take a lot to beat him tonight, Michael. From what I'm told, he's been spending extra hours in the gym in anticipation of getting in the ring with this guy.
What else can we say? He can talk all he wants, but if he wants to be a force in the WWE, he's going to have to prove it in the ring.
He's taking off his shirt and throwing it to the crowd.
There's the European uppercut. A brutal shot with the forearm. Not every move is designed to get the fans off their feet. This display of acrobatics is simply remarkable.
Oh, no fault for it. Yeah, I got to dial up my buddies.
Eddie Guerrero. Oh, we know what he's doing, Michael. Go for the second. And with the completion, we see three amigos.
This could be the turning point, Cole.
Whoa. Hey, stay down. You got an act there. I'll make sure you're good before you try to stand up.
Oh, and it's a reversal. Eddie Guerrero turns it around. Knocked him right off his feet.
Yeah, no kidding.
He's going for it all. He's not getting up.
You can't like his chance.
Viva La Raza, the frog splash.
He's back in control here.
Three, no, a kick out just in time.
He's got some more fight in him, guys.
That one misses big time.
Better luck next time.
And the animal is all fired up. Batista showing the WWE Universe his rage and emotion. Big miss for him there.
And he'll likely pay for it here.
Ain't no stopping him now.
If this continues, we could be talking about something no one wants to discuss. Facial reconstructive surgery.
Eddie Guerrero. Oh, we know what he's doing, Michael. Go for the second. And with the completion, we see three amigos.
Game, set, match. This one is over. When this guy's on, look out. This might be the end of the road for him, Byron.
Well, if he can't get back to his feet, you're absolutely right.
Well, those kind of acrobatics will keep the eyes of the WWE Universe on you at all times. And Eddie Guerrero heads for the top rope. Incoming.
He is a one-man gang in there.
Oh, because I got my signature.
Oh, he's able to reverse it. That's perfectly placed. And how you land the big strike.
Eddie Guerrero is on the attack now.
Oh, and he's still down, Byron.
Things definitely aren't looking very good for him right now.
I don't like the look in his eye here, folks. He's not looking good here, Byron.
No, he's got to get up, and he's got to get up now.
Why can't I jump? You're too far?
Eddie Guerrero's on the attack now.
Eddie Guerrero looking to attack from high. Doesn't show any signs of getting up here, guys.
No, he's taking one heck of a beating, Michael.
I literally can't jump to the piece. Oh, yeah, stand up so bad. Here.
Big move coming. And he executes a picture-perfect Russian leg sweep. And Eddie Guerrero heads for the top rope.
This could be it for him, guys. Yeah, he's on Dream Street.
I can't jump.
And it's Batista with a reversal.
Whoa, down he goes.
That was impressive, Cole.
Spear.
Incredible.
Warm up the bus. This one is over.
And here comes Batista.
Such a dangerous hold. And there it is, boys.
Okay, that's BS. I had a frog splash on him, and he instantly...
He had it locked up and made his opponent tap out.
But he hits me with a spear and puts me in a beast fight, and it's all good. I hit him with 2-3 Omegas. 2-3 Omegas. And granted, I mean, try to pin him after the second one. But... I got called BS on that.
Here is your winner, Batista.
Big win here to start the show.
And if that match is any indication of what to expect here tonight, we are in for an amazing evening.
Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
On him next. Super Tone? He just did a promo. Okay. Whatever he wants to do.
Not the first time and probably not the last time we'll hear from him.
He ain't messing around.
Tonight.
Let's see what he has to say.
Can I do another promo later? He can come out and apologize. Say he's sorry for what he said. He got up on all their still thumbs down. He can try to come out and say he's sorry for what he said. Look, it's like how disappointed he looks. He doesn't even want to say it. He's so upset, but yeah, he wants to say this. So.
They say pride comes before the fall.
I can be.
We shall
and
see.
Tonight is no different. I'm in the mood to shake things up. And tonight, I'd like to help a certain superstar to make this. I'd like the help of a certain superstar to make this special. And that superstar is Albert. Oh. Calling out Albert.
Wonder what's on his mind.
You know this guy came prepared.
He's not going to keep us waiting, so let's find out.
So there's a piercing around his neck, too, for a second. I was hesitant to come out here. I have no idea what you're up to. I really don't know what to expect. On the other hand, I've never been one to say no on television time. One to say no to television time. So here I am to hear you out. when I look at you, I see someone the same fire passion that I have for it, for this business. We both have to make history, and I say we do it together. I say we become the greatest tag team in the entire history of this industry. You really want to form a tag team with me. You know who I am, right? And what I do to people, I've made it a habit in my career to not trust any other superstars. I'm only here for me, but maybe there's something more to this. Maybe this is an opportunity to learn and grow. Hell yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Me and you are going to be unstoppable. Every single person in this crowd is going to love us. And why? Because we love them like that. But you just... And we're doing this alone. We want the WWE Universe behind us. Think about it with me. Him and all of you, the WWE can finally be great again.
Promo's over. It's time to wake up.
Next time I have trouble sleeping, do me a favor, play that thing a couple times.
Not exactly world-shattering, but I guess he tried.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, I said he was going to come out and apologize, but it still doesn't make any sense to me. Are they heel or are they face?
It'll be tough for the next match to be as good, but we shall see. Singles match on tap next.
I don't understand anymore. I don't. I
don't move. We have a great match coming up next.
It'll be Asuka against Bayley.
You don't want to miss it.
I'm going to... I don't know. Who should I be? Kind of wishing I had viewers right now to help me out, pick somebody out. Okay. It shouldn't be this hard of a decision. I like them both. I'm gonna be Bayley, mainly because she's champion. That is the reason I'm picking Bayley. I mean, I guess I could have just went ahead and not played this match.
Making her way to the ring, from Osaka, Japan, Asuka!
Folks, here comes Asuka, one of this generation's true greats, Cole, and I'm talking...
San Jose, California, the SmackDown Women's Champion, Bayley.
Byron, you have to love Bayley's enthusiasm, am I right?
You're absolutely right, Michael. It's hard not to smile when Bayley's around.
And guys, I hope Santa was good to you this morning.
Oh, he's always good to me, Cole. Though I'm pretty sure Saxton ended up with coal in his stocking.
The competitor is going to start this match up with the usual handshake.
No, they're not, Cole. A little disrespect on display, and I don't blame them.
Yeah, I figured you'd love that.
This is it, the moment we've been waiting for. The time for talking is behind us. Now these two superstars will test one another's abilities and will like never before. This is about being the best.
I am a fan of both of them. The reason I picked Bayley.
A move like that is completely unnecessary, unless you want to degrade your opposition, of course.
For the benefit of our newer audience members, what can they expect to see from this woman?
Bring it on. This one is going to be one for the ages. I can feel it in these old bones of mine.
I do expect her to show her opponent and the rest of the WWE that she's going to be someone to reckon with for a long time to come.
Okay, so stop doing that faster. Maybe.
Like, great offense by that? Bayley.
Okay, don't try it. I don't even have to say button. Is it the same button?
Her acrobatic skills never cease to amaze me. That acrobatic maneuver clearly caught her off guard.
That move. And it wasn't working. I tried to hold Skuller and I thought she would just like a powerful punch.
Asuka looks stunned by that. When she agreed to this match, she knew this wasn't going to be easy.
This is where we might just see one of these women pull away from the other for good.
That mistake, yeah.
Oh, and she gets her with the elbow.
Running out of time here.
Oh, come on, get in there.
She's in a bad way here.
Bottom line, she's got to get up. She can't win this match on her back.
I was about to say they're pretty even until the health bars came back up. Oscar is slow.
She's flipped a switch and the light is on. Escapes trouble there. And she lands a ferocious elbow.
Oh, nice suplex.
No doubt about that one.
Oh, here it comes. Bayley to belly. This one is over. Unbelievable. This singles match is over.
Here is your winner, Bayley.
And that's a win for Bayley.
Hey, she was the better woman of the two tonight. It's that simple.
What a match. And a quick thank you to everybody for spending part of their Christmas with us here at the WWE.
It was a great match. On to the next. Batista. He was out there earlier too. Batista, 2010. I hate when they put the dates there. Like, there's not another Batista in the game. Like, they don't put Andre the Giant and put the date there. This is just very confusing to me. Like, the John Cena's, I can understand. The Kurt Angle, I can understand them putting the
looks like he's going to grace us with his presence once more. Man, it's on now. This could honestly be about a few things. Let's find out.
This is going to be another one in the DLC. That one fan was booing him, and he looked back at him. The coward lives in the shadows, they're waiting a perfect moment to strike. The coward is afraid to show their face because they can't handle burdens of their actions. A coward is like all of you, sitting in the audience, watching from their comfortable seats while injustice transpires in this room. That's all he's saying. I suppose I came out here to make a name for myself, didn't I? Yeah, we're doing this, and there's no avoiding it. So I might as well just get on with it.
You mad, bro? I guess so.
We're not going to wait for the next big event. We're going to do this right here, right now. Drex, come here. Get out here. That rhymes. Drex just got called out by Batista.
Wonder what this is about. Here we go. He's not going to keep us waiting, so let's find out.
This just looks like a dominant fight. Who's taller? He's a little bit taller. He's all confused. Stop. No, man. You're not going to do that thing you always do. You're not going to avoid a conflict with me because I'm bringing it right to you. Who the hell do you think you are coming out here and you're interrupting me? Do you have any idea who I am? You've got 5 seconds to explain why you're out here and 3 of them just to watch. I don't understand this promo. He called him out. I don't understand the call out promos at all.
Okay, then.
I ain't here to be on some talk show. You either want to match or not, because I'm about ready to start it up right now. Get a ref, get a bell, and let's do this thing. Slow your roll, homeboy. I ain't ready. I don't got my lucky undies on. Maybe next time, or maybe some other time. I'll just get back to you on it. Just relax. I'll let you know when I'm feeling it. The piece that looks like he's regretting calling Drex out here.
Okay.
If it was your goal to make me angry, then congratulations, you succeeded. I was going to content with just beating you into a pile of convulsing gear, but now I'm really going to make you hurt.
A fine line between being confident and being an egomaniac.
Forget your friends, your family. Listen to yourself. That nagging voice in your head says, do you really want to do this? But you, because you don't. Trust me.
Not making any friends, but not really concerned about it either.
There's so much bass in your voice when someone like me is walking around here. I'll talk any way I damn please. And if you think for a second I'm afraid of the likes of you, you are sorely mistaken. You're telling me to take the bass out, but you won't do anything about it. It looks like there's someone here saying, I'm going to do you a favor. I'm going to let you walk out of here. You're getting a pass. You're welcome. Don't make me regret my generosity.
I think I speak for all of us when I say,
Next time I have trouble sleeping, do me a favor. Play that thing a couple times.
Not exactly world-shattering, but I guess he tried.
He told him to get out of the ring. I don't understand when it says that kind of stuff, when they call him out. Like, they need to... 2K needs to fix that. Jinder Mahal promotion. Self-promotion. Do I gotta speak in Indie? Do I need to read it in Indie?
What could this be about? And the wait is finally over. I'm sure the WWE Universe is dying to know what's going on.
Back the cameraman. Who disappeared? You know, when I come out to this ring tonight, I had an entire speech ready to deliver. However, the second I stepped out into the arena, my mind went completely blank. Not because of nerves or lack of preparation, but because of the anxious...
Not making any friends, but not really concerned about it
either. I'm going to remain calm. These people are not worth your time. No, don't get angry. Relax. These people are crap on the bottom of the shoe. Settle yourself. Is he talking to him, sir? Whether or not you morons want to admit it, I'm the best thing in the WWE today. I'm not other superstars on their back. I don't care what any of you P-brain viewers think of me or how I handle my business. The only thing I'm concerned about is money. Money in the ring? There's nothing I won't do in a WWE. Title matches, triple threats, fatal four ways, ladder matches, extreme rules handicap matches, tag matches, elimination chamber, hell in a cell, hot dog on pole matches, I spy with my little eye matches. This is why I'm best. That's it. I've had it with you people. If you're not going to show me the stuff I deserve, I refuse to allow you. My presence,
now we know what we have in store. That was top notch right there. I love it. Let's get it going.
Why? Is my question. Why?
I can't wait to see how the rest of the card shakes out here. Sit tight for singles action.
Jesse Johnson,
coming up.
Page, I will not be playing this match.
Now, don't go anywhere. We have a classic coming up. We have a real fan favorite versus Paige.
Jesse Johnson has actually been doing pretty good as of late.
Making her way to the ring, from Columbus, Ohio, Jesse Johnson.
One-on-one action coming up here, guys, and I'm willing to bet this will be one we won't sue.
That's not supposed to be unless she comes out.
And her opponent.
And
And there's the bell. And here we go. This is the type of battle that you can show someone who's new to our brand of entertainment and say, this is what WWE's all about.
The only thing that would make this match more enjoyable to watch would be if I was calling it without you two bozos interrupting me.
Ooh. I assure you guys, this will be a match that this Baton Rouge crowd will not soon forget.
Well, on the topic of Paige here, what kind of attack is she going to mount here?
Cole, don't mind me. I'm just going to sit back and enjoy the spectacle in this one. It has all the makings of a legendary WWE bout.
And a powerful forearm. And she's driven to the mat hard.
Oh, yeah, here's Paige.
Boy. Tornado.
And she hits a DDT that would make Jake Roberts blush.
Look at Paige making her move.
Rampage.
Paige Turner!
This could be it for her.
On the ramp, yeah, that's
a quick finish! Can she do it? And she kicks out with relative ease.
Clearly not enough damage done.
Hold on, guys. This isn't good.
No question about it, Cole.
Is she doing a rampage from the top?
Oh, my goodness. Man. Rampage from the ropes.
She's got a chance to win it here.
Oh, man. I mean, that was so close. I thought it was over.
Just needs to do more damage.
And she comes up with a big counter. She's looking to end it early, and she gets the shoulders up.
It's going to take more than that to keep her down.
Looks like Paige is starting to slip a bit.
To be expected, though, given the competition she's in there with tonight.
Let's be honest, though. She's in pretty good shape here. It's her opponent who should be concerned. I mean, I lost track of how many finishers she's been on the receiving end of.
Well, it was just a few moments ago that it looked like she was going to sail to victory.
And the ropes break this one up.
Great ring awareness there, Michael.
And she's still not moving.
I don't think she can recover from this, Cole.
What's going to happen? This match could go anywhere.
Victory here would undoubtedly put the rest of the Divas locker room on notice.
Look at the look in her eyes. She's in the zone now.
Well, moves like that at this stage are not to win any match. They're just used to
strong kick.
Beautiful.
She's got it now.
Paige is in trouble.
She's looking at it early. Two. And a kick out at 2.5.
She powered out there, Michael.
Needed a three.
She wants to finish this.
I don't think she's a challenger.
She might have to think that's it.
We may be looking at our winner here, guys.
She's got the shoulders down. One, two. Shoulder got up, but I don't think it was in time. Come on, ref. Finish the count.
She's not done yet.
You can see the confidence just beaming from her right now. Well, I guess that'll teach her a lesson.
Excellent move to get out.
That's how you slam an opponent down with authority.
Once you tap out, this one I was talking about, how good she was doing.
There's the tap. There's the tap. This one's over.
Here is your winner, Paige.
Paige picks up the victory here tonight.
There's few things more humiliating than tapping out to your opponent.
What a match, and a quick thank you to everybody for spending part of their Christmas with us here at the WWE.
You know, I was just talking about how good.
Don't move.
Is
we have a great match coming up next.
It's Jimmy Uso against an imposing adversary.
Oh, I cannot wait.
Jimmy Uso versus the Beef. Versus the United States champion, the Beef. Oh, it is a it's a champion versus champion match. Tag team versus. Tag team champion versus. The Beef.
Making his way to the ring, accompanied by Jey Uso, representing the Usos from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 251 pounds, one half of the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, Jimmy Uso.
Jimmy Uso on his way to the ring now, and this is a big opportunity for Jimmy tonight.
And before I forget, allow me to wish everybody out there a very Merry Christmas.
You know, I can't help but wonder what I did wrong.
The ruining storyline here. I understand it's December in the game. But they're ruining my storyline. Not really storylines, but you know. Actually, I don't know. It's storylines. Whatever else. United States champion.
And his opponent from the pits of hell, weighing in at 220 pounds, the United States champion, Andrew.
Singles action on its way, and it sounds like this arena is more than ready to kick this one off.
So is social media, Michael. The opening bell hasn't even rung, and yet both these superstars are already trending.
And guys, I hope Santa was good to you this morning.
Oh, he's always good to me, Cole. Though I'm pretty sure Saxton ended up with coal in his stocking.
That the Rock's in a Beef mask. They don't attempt the Beef.
All right, it's time to get this match going.
And man, I never get tired of watching these guys compete.
God, what a stiff shot. And right on the mark.
The beef. Oh.
Let's talk briefly about Jimmy Uso. For those that haven't seen much of him, what can we expect tactic-wise from him tonight?
I like what I've seen from Jimmy Uso of late, guys. Seems to me he's really dedicated himself to getting better each time he steps in the ring.
Here in the early going, he's got a spring in his step and some fire in his eyes. We'll see if that translates to a victory.
Lights up his chest with a chop.
A sickening thud as he lands hard. From what we've seen and heard tonight, there must be serious injuries.
Jimmy Uso turned his back on his friends and the WWE Universe a long time ago. Dressed in all black, Jimmy's a ruthless rule breaker who doesn't care what anyone has to say about him or his actions.
Jimmy Uso showing some expert prowess here. Looks like Jimmy Uso starting to sweat here. I fully expect him to bounce back, though. This is the type of one-on-one atmosphere where he thrives.
He just has to make sure this doesn't get too out of hand for him. Sometimes, momentum has a way of permanently swinging one way. That's what he wants to avoid here.
I once considered the Usos close friends. Jimmy's conduct since the inaugural SmackDown Tag Team title tournament in 2015 has been less than becoming. The saddest quick pin attempt here. And the kick out.
What a kick out.
Jimmy Uso climbing up.
And Byron, he's still down after that one.
Yeah, that did some big time. Look at this.
On the shoulders here.
And it could be a long way down from there.
That's a brutal way to have to land on the canvas. He lands a jarring forearm.
Oh man, what a hit.
Knocked right off the apron.
He's making a statement here with this attack. This guy's a machine. Back now inside the ring. We've seen this before.
And he lands the slam.
This could be it, guys.
What is Jimmy Uso's best strategy at this point? He doesn't want to absorb much more punishment if he wants to win this match.
I'd never count this guy out, but I'll tell you what, he's not looking so hot right now. He's really going to need to find a way to get back in this thing.
Hey, he can still win this thing, guys. We've all seen him come back from much worse.
Flips the script on him there. He misses there.
You just can't miss by that much, Cole.
Kick!
He might just win this thing right here.
Oh, yeah.
Choke slam!
See you, Jimmy.
He may get the three count right there.
That's just going to make the beef mad. Unless he's distracted.
A blatant disregard for the rules here. Taking him a while to get up here.
I don't think he has anything left, Michael.
He gets him with a reversal.
Oh, there's some good contact there by Jimmy Uso.
He's too quick for him there.
Enjoy this real show, man. Oh, I thought D was going to show
him. Oh, what impact? What?
I think he was thinking about it. He's like, you know what? I want to get disqualified.
The knee lands.
I kind of forgot what he was doing when he bounced it.
Shoulders down. This could be it.
ZV.
He doesn't appear to be in a hurry to get up here.
I just don't think he has it in him anymore.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. That shot hit the opponent exactly in the right spot. What accuracy. When his strikes land, you can feel it in the first few rows. Man, Jimmy Uso, what offense. Jim Super Kick!
Here's where Jimmy can win this thing.
Jimmy Uso did it.
Beat him.
What a huge win.
I had to beat his head at one. Yeah.
That's a big, big win. Man, what a hard-fought victory for him tonight. I'm not sure if he was going to pull it out, but he did.
Wait a minute. What's going through his mind?
No, this has been a very personal rivalry for many, many months now. And, not this personal. Not the steel chair. Oh, my God. Stop him. Get in there, rep, and stop him.
It wasn't even a rivalry. Honestly, Jimmy was not a rival. He does not run. Well, that's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. I keep forgetting I changed it. See you on Thursday for NXT. I'm out.